All right, so in a previous video, I was mentioning that about buying old equipment. All right, and this right here is the Akai MPC 2500, and it's a standalone machine. All right, but it has MIDI on the back of it. Okay, MIDI in, MIDI out, and what you can do with that is you can hook it up to your sound card, and then that way you can control stuff on the computer. Right, so like let's say you have this unit, let's say you bought like a, you got a really good deal on an MPC or something, and you don't know what to do with it. Like it's really old school, and you've never used anything like that before. And maybe you try it, and you don't really like the workflow and stuff. And that's understandable, right? Especially today, the stuff is so advanced and all that. But if you really don't like the workflow of it, and you really don't want to use it for what it is, I mean, that's okay. I understand. So what you could do then is at least use it as a controller. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to do that. Now it depends on the software that you have. Okay, right here I'm using Studio One from Personas. There's also Ableton Live, and then of course there's other things like FL Studio and all that. But they're pretty much all the same here. Okay, and right here in Studio One, I loaded up this synth right here. Okay, it's a string synth. Let's check it out. Okay, that's with my mouse. All right, now the thing is, if you look here on the left, you can see that this is the ins and outs here, okay, of this track. Now, right now it says none. You go here, it shows the Akai, but that's because I put that in the settings, all right? Once I activate this, you can see right here, I can control it with the pads, all right? And the same thing right here for all inputs, same thing, all inputs. Okay, and that's because, the thing is, usually you don't have to really mess with the stuff in the software too much, the settings and all that, because a lot of times you just put all inputs and you're good to go, right? Because it's checking for all the inputs that are hooked up to this software. So in this case, on the MPC, I'm not too sure if you could see right here, if you could see the screen too well, is I set it for MIDI 1A, right? Here it's off MIDI 1A. So it's 2A, 3A, whatever. If I have different, pieces of hardware like this, if I have this or another MPC or a keyboard or whatever, then I'm going to want to assign that to a specific MIDI channel, and then over here on the software, I want to, do the same thing, right? So that's why, like, it's for this in this scenario, it's only one unit I'm using here, so it doesn't really matter what channel of media it's on, right? So, and that's why, like, you could put all inputs, or you could put a specific channel, whatever. And as you can hear, see on the MPC, you got these four banks here. It goes higher, right? So it actually, you can actually use that as well. That's really cool. All right, so that way it's not just about hitting the pads, but you can also do that as well and stuff. And of course, you can use this depending on, your MIDI hookup. You can also use it for the play and stop features and all that stuff. And other things too. You can assign, you can get really advanced with it, and you can assign different knobs and buttons to do different things in the DAW, depending on the DAW and how advanced, it'll let you go, whatever. But yeah, it's pretty much it. So that's just to control a synth, all right? Okay, so another thing too is also to use this to control drums as well. So, I mean, it applies to whatever synth you're using, whatever plugin you're adding in that you want to control with the MPC, all right? So in this case, you got Impact XT that comes with Studio One. You could load up different samples, like drums or whatever. So right here, I added some kick, snare. All right. But then if I want to control it with here, I set it again. I set all inputs. All right. And check it out. Right. So that way you can use this as a controller, or even if you're using this, as a standalone, like if you use it all the time, making beats just on this. But then once in a while, you just feel like doing something like just with the software or whatever, but you want to have a controller. Well, this is the way to go then, So MIDI is the key here, because I know a lot of people are probably not really messing with MIDI today because everything's about USB. And I understand that, but the thing is, MIDI can be very powerful depending on the equipment that you have and all that. Because don't forget, I mean, there's a lot of good deals you can get out there for really old equipment that people are getting rid of. If you just feel like, I have something new to play with, well, then you do that. You get something old, hook it up with MIDI, and then you're good to go. All right, so let's say you want to add your own unit here into the settings of Studio One. Okay, you go to Studio One, Options, and then you got external devices here. What I did was I added this one here. There is none, like there's no default one for like a Akai MPC 2500. So I added this myself. This is what I call it, the controller. And all MIDI channels received from my sound card, sent to the sound card, and that's pretty much it. All right. Now this one here I also added because I wanted to add this here, the MIDI clock, start, time code, and all that. I want to add that. That's a separate thing. That's when I want to use it to, when I want to track out my beats into the software, that's when I need to use this one. This is not for like controlling an instrument or whatever. This is strictly like this input here I put, it's just strictly to dump my stuff into the DAW and then I can mix from there. So anyway, basically it's just that. It's very, very simple. And it might take a bit of tweaking on your part, you know, depending on your setup and everything, but that's about it. You know, you just add that. If you want to add a new device, you know, it's something like this. You can add a new instrument, control surface, whatever, you know. So you just, you know, play around with it and then you'll see, you know, how simple it is. You know, it's not hard, you know, it's not hard. So like, for example, here, new keyboard, that's the one I used for the MPC 2500 controller. This one here, new instrument. As you can see, it's got the send MIDI clock and all that. That's the one I used to, you know, to trigger the stop play and all that stuff. So that's a separate one I added. All right, so that's it for me. Make sure you subscribe and now go make some beats.